Hi guys, this is Tarvia, the cleaning lady. I am coming to you today to give you a few tips on some cleaning ideas and products that I've discovered that helps with a lot of things. My cameraman, he's going to be moving back and forth with me, so if you guys can be patient with me. Before we get started, I want you to know that you can follow me at www.tarviabillstheCleaningLady.com. That is my website. I'm also on Facebook, Instagram, and YouTube. So I guess you know I'm on YouTube because this is a YouTube video. But anyway, let's get started. Can you come over here for a minute? I'm going to show you guys. This is a client of mine who has concerns about the mold in her bathroom. So if you could go around and see kind of like the mold. It's really, really dark here. So I did some investigating work on about the mold. So the first thing we're going to try is some bleach here, and this is a powder bleach I have here. I've never used this before, so this is going to be brand new for me as well for you. Now you can take the bleach, and I guess I better put my gloves on because this maybe is kind of strong. We're going to take the bleach and we're going to soak it in the cotton balls in the bleach. And what that's going to do is that we're going to line, put the cotton balls on where the mold is. And so I'm hoping and praying that it kind of lifts the mold up. But I do know for a fact, because I've done it at several homes, is that, okay, this is kind of strong. The water's hot. So I have stuck the cotton balls, and like I said, this is just bleach and water, and she has a powder bleach, but I would do this with just straight hard bleach, so we have to dilute it with some water. This is my first time ever hearing a powder bleach, and it smells just like bleach too. Not as strong, but it smells just like bleach. So I'm gonna let those soak in there, and then I'm gonna place them where the mold is. And this just try to, you know, kind of sort of helps you without the re-caulking, to keep you from re-caulking the whole bathroom. I read up on this and it's supposed to help you, so I'm going to kind of like scatter them out and see if it works on here. So I guess these cotton balls are good besides removing nail polish on. And why we didn't this work, once you get rid of the mold, guys, you can take any type of tea tree oil, I mean, like you use for your hair, or I use tea tree oil to bathe in, especially if I get like mosquito bites or different things like that. Insect bites is real good for that. But you can take tea tree oil once you get the mold up and put the tea tree oil, just spray it, don't rinse it, or however you want to do it. You can just take the tea tree oil, and that prevents the mold from coming back. I did that at my residence because I had mold there before too as well. And it just kind of, you know, prevents it from going back. Don't ask me why, but it does. And I'll show you a bottle of the tea tree oil that I use. So this is, like I said, this is my first time using this. So I'm going to place the bleached cotton balls there to see if it works. Now in the meantime, while that's doing that, I'm going to show y'all. Y'all know that my favorite thing is to clean. We have the ring around her tub. Can you get a picture of that up close for me? The ring around her tub. Y'all, you guys can see this, where it's just kind of like built up in here, kind of like the soap scum. See, it's coming off on my glove. So that is dirt, but it's also stained here. It's real bad in the bottom of the tub. So what we're gonna do with that, of course, I'm gonna get my favorite thing over here for you. I'm gonna put my little bucket over here. My favorite thing, of course, you guys know, is the Lysol toilet bowl cleaner. I love it. I told you it'll clean you. So I'll just kind of take a little bit of this and put it in the bottom of the tub. And this is in itself is a strong bleach. The toilet bowl cleaner. You can see it'll lighten up the tub too. You'll better see the lines once you put it in. But it works really well. I always make a ring around the tub. To do that, actually, I'm going to try it along here to see if it'll lighten that up too as well. So we're going to try this out together. So if it doesn't work, hey, it's a lesson learned for all of us. And of course, while I'm letting that sit, I know everybody is used to using the the vinegar with the peroxide and baking soda and the Dawn dishwasher. And that works sometimes on some things, guys. Not on everything. With that, I discovered with that to get your tub white and stuff, that has to sit a while. But it is good for that. You know, if you have the time to let your figure tub up and put those ingredients in to let it sit to get your tub white, it does work because I have tried that. So why I got this working over here, which I have, I'm going to tell those who are just joining in, it's the cotton balls with powdered bleach on it. We're going to see if that takes away the mold. But I'm telling you, I always carry the tea tree oil around with me because I have clients' house that had mold before. So when I'm doing their tub or their shower, I just kind of take it and sprinkle it around. You know, that's just to keep the mold from returning. So this is the one that I use, and I think I picked it up at Walmart maybe for like $6.38 or something like that. So I kind of keep that with me as well. That's really good. And I have a scrub brush for the tub, but I also believe in Brillo pads and SOS pads, especially for something like this. I'm hoping that the bleach will help with the mold. If not, then we're going to have to go to something stronger. You know, they might have to lift it up and do a little bit of more caulking. And also, another tip for the bathroom today I want to share with you guys is that I did try with a client. It works. If you would take a lemon, if you would just take a lemon, cut it in half, and take it around here where the water stains is, guys. Just take the lemon all the way around the inside of the lemon. Not the hole, just the inside of the lemon. All on these water spots. Anything that has silver or chrome, and put that around there and wipe it off. It'll get it back shining just like brand new. Trust me, that really works. Also, I'm going to show you this right here is the soap scum, dirt buildup on the shower curtain. I'm going to show you, hopefully here I can show you how to take your shower curtain and put it in the tub with the Morton salt. All you have to do is run the tub full of water, go from salt from end to end, and put the shower liner in the water, soak it, you know, kind of dip it, and that will also get your curtain, it'll keep it from being this way. So that's another project we're going to be working on here, hopefully once we get the tub and things done. But while that is sitting, I'm going to go over here, step over here to the sink, and show you another trick also too. Now you can take the lemon too for this, but you know, I found this is a lot easier. Get you a couple of paper towels. You can do them however you want. And this is my vinegar bottle. This is straight vinegar. And you just kind of cut it on. Kind of spray it down, soak it down. And you show this face. We have the water spots and everything on this too as well on my sink. I usually use the lemon just like for my showers because the lemon also picks up the soap scum. So I use that in the shower. And also the vinegar too, guys, is also good for your shower heads too. It opens it up. You can stick that up. Pour a little bit of vinegar in a glass or an old jar. Stick it up to the head of the shower. And let it soak for a little bit, and then run it, opens it, all that back up too. Just in case y'all didn't know that too, that works too. So I'm soaking my paper towel down. The vinegar is kind of strong, huh? And you just kind of take it and wrap it wherever you want it, you know, and let it sit for the water spots. Now I know you're saying, why come you don't just spray it directly on there? Because it doesn't take effect like that. This gives it time to kind of like soak while it's on there. So usually just let that soak down there at the back. Got it on my towel. Just keep my towel moist and, you know, see if that's going to work to get that up too. And those are your ones. So we got the vinegar over here for the hard water spots on the sink and get the chrome to back to shining. We got that over there. Then I have Lysol toilet bowl cleaner here in the blue in the corner over here in my tub to try to see if it prevents with the mold. And then I have the soaked bleach cotton balls to see if that's going to work too. Now we know I've already done a video before that we already know that the Lysol toilet bowl cleaner will get all this grout and stuff out here. We know that a cleaner to make that super duper white. And I'm gonna put some on the back of this to see if it'll lift this up. I know I'm keeping Lysol in business, boy. I tell you what. I buy this by the case, boy. Costco, they see me coming, they get the runner, they know what I want. Cause this is so freaking good. I love it. And like I said, it's a good cleaner. It cleans about everything. So I love that. I'm gonna step over here now and I'm gonna get my new Brillo pads here. So, and I usually use SOS pad, but today I said I wanna try a Brillo pad, see how that's gonna work. So my first thing is gonna do, I'm going to try to see if we got any type of progress from the Lysol over here in this corner with the mold. So I'm gonna use that, and I'm gonna use the Brillo and my little scrub brush. So put the water on, give me a little bit of water, wet my brush, and I'm gonna wet my Brillo pad too. Yeah, that's my phone ringing, it's in the other room, so I don't have time. But anyway, so here's the Brillo pad. So I'm gonna try to go along. So as we can see already, the Lysol is working on this mold. With the SOS pad, it's lifting it up. You guys, can you get in there so they can see that? It's lifting it up. It's making it a whole lot lighter than I expected, with nothing on it. So we know that it eats through it. So you remember it was all started out this dark. So I bet you with a little bit of elbow grease, it's gonna lift that right on up. Mm. Yeah, look at that, it's lifting it right on up. So I told you Lysol will do, this toilet bowl cleaner will do everything. It'll clean you. So we see that works. Can you get that in there good to see that's how this Once we get it back to basically a natural color, that's when you'll put the tea tree oil in there to try to get it back. To prevent it from coming back. So I'm going to try this little spot over here that we put the bleach on with the cotton ball. You see that? Let's see if that comes with the bleach. And actually with the bleach and the Lysol, it's lightening that too as well. Look at that. Did you see that? Mm-hmm. Can you get a close-up in on that? Okay, guys. So that now we know that it does work with the bleach and with the Lysol, so that did make it lighter. So let me go to a bigger spot here, make sure we get the same results. Okay, so I have straight bleach on there. I'm gonna put some more Lysol and see if that's gonna be, well, look at that. You better hush your mouth and keep on talking. Look at that, guys. Now that's with the bleach on the cotton ball. Now don't forget, that's the bleach on the cotton ball and the Lysol. Can you see the difference? The difference in that. So we know for a fact that does work. And the only thing I did was remind you is that I put the bleach on the cotton ball. Let it sit probably what about, it was like 7 minutes, 7 to 8 minutes. I came back with a Brillo or SOS pad. I dipped a little bit in the Lysol toilet bowl cleaner, and it's lifting up our mold. So it's lifting up my mold. And I know my client, she's gonna be too happy. And this prevents the caulking.
Looks good.
Yes. So that's a totally different than what it started. Yeah, so I know you guys can notice that. So I'm going to take these same pads and stick them here. I love this stuff, believe it or not. I'm always trying stuff out, so I love this. So I'm going to let that sit on there, and then I'm going to take my other ones and put them over here. Since we know that this works. And again, I'm gonna keep using my Lysol with it. Because I think it's a double agent. I think it's making it more powerful. You know, just that. Oh, God, I wear my cotton balls. I think it's making it more powerful than just that. So, with that being said, now we're going to try the bottom of the tub. And the yellow that you're seeing, this is from my, this is only from my Brillo pads. From me scrubbing. And I'm thinking it's working.
It's working.
Yeah, it's where I'm thinking that it's eating through it. So look at that. I told y'all I get excited about cleaning stuff. I cannot wait to show you guys how to keep the soap scum and everything from your glass shower doors. You're not going to believe what cleans it. No, it is not Lysol. It's not the Lysol toilet bowl cleaner, but you guys are not going to believe what keeps the soap scum from building up on your shower after you clean it real good. After you know you're getting or you splash the water and the soap right, you're not gonna believe what keeps it off and keeps it clean. I know that's another little trick. I was so excited when I figured that out. But anyway, so now with that going on, I'm going to I'll wet my brush for let me re-wet it again. So we're going to take the light. Well, actually, I'm just going to take the same Brillo pad. And we're going to try to see how the bottom of the tub looks. Now, remember, she had we saw the ring. But we're going to see how the bottom of the tub looks. And the ring, just to be honest with you, it's just probably more dirt. But this down here in the bottom of the tub is build up. It's build up. So, and I can't stand build up. I cannot stand build up. So we know, see, like this is automatically coming up because this is what basically what you call it a ring around a tub. My mom used to say, I don't want to see no brown ring in that tub unless you know it's not clean. So this is, and I know everybody doesn't have time to scrub with an SOS pad. That's why you get your stick. But I'm more hands on, I keep scrubbing till I see it. I'm like that with mirrors too. Oh my God, I get obsessed with them. So I'm gonna get down here and I'm gonna go ahead and clean out the whole entire tub so we can see. And I'm just wiping. Yes, and I do this for all my homes, especially those that need care and stuff. And this lady just expressed her concern about me cleaning, but she didn't give me specifics on what, you know, to do. So I asked her, and here we go. And a lot of people are into the natural, so if you can find, like, I think that's why she has the powder bleach. They use natural products, so I told her I'll have to bring in something stronger to get the tub to the performance that she wanted it to be in. The condition that she would like for it to look, anyway, put it that way. Mm-hmm. And again, this yellow you're seeing is just from the Brillo pad. Okay. And I actually believe that's still eating through that. Okay, guys, so here we go. Get a little red. So I can wash it, see. Hold on. Wash it, see. Here we go. Well, here we go. I think she'll be able to enjoy her bubble bath today. Yeah. What you think?
Looks good.
A totally different tub. I think she'll be able to enjoy her bath today. Now she'll invest in her a good pillow. She'll be good to go for the tub. So, this is my tub. This is the cleaning lady's tub. Can you get that?
Got it.
And see, guys, that's nothing but Lysol toilet bowl cleaner and my SOS pad or my Brillo pad. That's it. Totally different tub. Totally different cup, even from the bottom. So, I am going to I'll make a little hole here. Get all this down. And back here. So, I have this, the bottom part rinsed out. I want to show you guys something else before I actually start scrubbing my tub in its entirety, because I'm giving my bleach time to sit. But I'm going to show you what I was telling you about earlier. I think it's a totally different tub. What do you think?
Looks good. Good.
So I'm going to show you what I was talking about real quickly, because I have to re-scrub the tub because I have salt in it. Hold on.
Looks a lot better.
Okay, so we got a brand new shower curtain here. You see, I'm taking it out of the package. And like I said, I told you my lady is a environment and health. They're health nuts, so. I know, they just, it drives me cuckoo for Cocoa Puffs. Everything says, I said, you got salt there? No, I have sea salt. That's what she told me. I got sea salt. Really? I need some salt. So, I had to stop this morning and get some salt. She has the curtain. Hold on. Well, I'm going to take the glove off. Hold on. She has the curtain, but not the salt. Okay. So here we go. So what I'm going to do is just going to take the Morton salt, and this is great value, so it doesn't matter what salt. Just take the iodized salt, and I just kind of sprinkle it in the tub. Just sprinkle it in the tub. Put as much as you want. I just, and then I'll just take the shower curtain, guys. The brand new curtain, Now you can probably put this in the washer. Your old one, to try to get it off. It works okay, but you got to wash a whole lot of time. So, and you may can spray that down with some Comet and then put it in the washer to see how that works for you too. I said I was going to try that, but I didn't have the time. So, I know I had posted this video before, but we can't find it to repost it. So, you're going to take your brand new shower curtain or your old one after you wash it if you get the soap scum and things off. But you just take it and you just kind of dip it in the water. And what that does is that the salt is getting between those little bristles and grooves in the curtain. And it will, I promise you, that it will keep all of the soap scum, the grout, the dirty, the filth from your boyfriend, your kids, your husband, when they take a shower, forget at the bottom of that curtain. I hate that with a passion, instead of going back out and buying a new curtain. This is all you have to do. They just keep doing it, giving a chance for the salt to get through everything. And that's it. If you don't feel it's enough, take the salt and pour it directly on there. And then you hang it. You hang it up. No soap, I guarantee it. No soap scum, none of this will be on the curtain. I promise you. Unless you just, if there's something like that, then you got to check if people that are bathing, since they're bathing, but it should not be like that at all. So we're going to rehang that after we get the tub clean like I want, but I just wanted to show you guys that little trick. But anyway, I thank you for taking out the time. Now I gotta get to work. But I just want to thank you right now for taking out the time to watch this video. Again, I am Tarvia Bills, the cleaning lady. And you can follow me on Facebook, Tarvia Bills, the cleaning lady. Or go to my webpage. I'm going to start posting little tips for you. If anybody has any questions, there's a place where you can comment on that. You can directly Facebook, Instagram me, or tweet me. I'm on Twitter as well. And it's always going to be Tarvia Bills, the cleaning lady. And please go to Facebook and like my page. Again, it's www.tarviabillstheCleaningLady.com. Thank you guys so much for watching. Guys, I completely forgot. I got so excited about the mold and jumped up so I could start cleaning. But I forgot to show you the sink. We forgot to come back to the sink. So remember, all I did was soak the paper towels in vinegar and we put it on here. So I'm gonna just kind of lift this up, and this is my vinegar. So I'm just gonna take a paper towel so I can show you how it comes up, and that will keep the water spots. That's all it is, vinegar water. And it gives you, it can come on this side, and it gives you back your shine. It just gives you back your shine. I want to show you that too as well. So that's the back, and this is still how that's how it originally looked. So that keeps all the soap scum and everything, and it works also too with the handle faucet. So that'll help you too with that as well. Okay, again, okay, I'm going to sign off now for sure. I got a lot of work to do, but thank you so much again for coming back to watch me again. And remember, I am Tarvia Bills, your cleaning lady.